Ranos here, and welcome to episode of Space Engineers. This episode takes a look at the more co-contained with doors by the Sleep One, and the recharging station by Alachi Dance Party. So, how about we move on to the... start with the cargo containers. So, there's present. So here, it is all the same containers, but instead of using the hatches, like the other one does, it uses the doors as the model instead. Yeah, just two different models to use. One you can access and one you can't. With the vanilla versions. These ones you can access all of them. This gives you a different look to make them look a bit nicer. And again, they are available on small ships with the medium containers, having a variety of different styles to them, with more conveyors on them. And the large ones also being different, so it has all large instead of having half large, half small. Yeah, pretty helpful. Let's look at that one. A handy container, if you ask me. Same as the other black ones here. And I can tell color and texture can be modified on all of them. And just the same with the ones with the hatches, the build cost also includes the build cost of the door. If I'm not mistaken, when I go to conveyor, I'm sure it's in the slot. There's the cap. I don't have the door. Not that bundle, anyway. I wonder what bundle was in. Let's find out. Yeah, there's all the ones with the doors. I don't actually know. Interesting. I'm pretty sure it's a vanilla thing. I think it is though, it's just in a different section. There we are. Not that one. But this one. Going right there. You can see they mesh in together. Pretty much the exact same size. It wasn't like the other one where you put the cap on. There was actually no reason to put an extra door on top rather than just a simple cap. Okay, let's go like that. Now then, this is not really much as a go over these as any different from the previous version. But you have the vanilla having 15,000 liters storage. This one's at 48,000, or 49,000 thereabouts. A little over 78,000. A little bit over 234,000. Then we've got the vanilla at large at 421,000, but closer to 422. This one being the same as that one. And this one being a teensy bit larger at 703,000. Lots of space. And then you just go with these ones that have got more storage too. However, all these ones being the same as each other. So, 8,000 add, 625, 375, and 125. Alright. Just them. Not really much else to say about these little buggers, is there? How about we move on to the recharge station by Alachi Dance Party, which adds this little thing. It's a tiny little thing you can add onto your wall, including a small ship variant, which allows you to recharge the power in your suit. And that's basically it. Instead of having to run to a place that, like to a med bay or somewhere like that, you just slap one of these around and recharge it back. And I do believe that cost is actually low enough, and I actually use quite a few bits. Like 25 steel plates, 2 construction components, 20 small steel tubes, 1 display, 2 computers, and 6 power cells. Oh, and 5 interior blades. So yeah, I'm not sure what these bars are about. Does it actually count as battery? No. Basically, up to it recharges your suit. But I'm in creative mode, so you can't actually see it recharge. And this battle can be modified, I think. Yes, it can. You can actually modify it. So, you can change it to... Where is it? That way. They show how much power and hydrogen is on the ship. Although using a script to make it only show how much power is available would actually be the better thing. Use a script so it just has a bar for the power on it. That would probably be best. Yeah, just get it to charge up. And you can use this one over here to charge as well. You can have it on your small ships. But how much does this one cost? 20 steel plates. Basically the same price. Just less interior plates. Interesting. You can go down the back too. So this can easily fit into the actual wall because it's a single block wide. I'll put it on the side of a ship. So that people are out mining, just hopping over here, recharge and go back to work. Stuff like that. So, yeah. That's all there is to say about it. Which, both of them are quite useful, especially the different containers of that one. The larger size would be quite helpful depending on what sort of base you're building. And not having any gaps will also help it become airtight. So you can use it as like a sort of wall between like the outside, if you want a building like that. And this will just be a handy little charge station to get your energy up to full. Especially if you're using one of those worlds where jetpacks are disabled. It'll still be a good one to use. So anyway, I'll have links for both mods down in the description below. So you can play around with these different style containers. As well as putting these little recharge stations for your crew. So they may stay fully powered and ready to work. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.